So students, we all were doing the comparative study of the respiratory organs. Till now, we have discussed about the lower invertebrates. In the lower invertebrates, we have touched two phyla, that is the annelida. Example we all have learned was the earthworm, and thereafter we have discussed about the spider respiratory organ. Today we will be talking about the respiratory or respiration in bony fish. Now let me give you a small brief about the fish. Now when we talk about the fish are of basically two types. The first is the cartilaginous fish and the bony fish. Now when we talk about the bony fish, so they belong, now all the fishes, they belong to the phylum Chordata, and Chordata we also tell them the vertebrata. So the animal, those who comprise of the notochord or the vertebral phylum, are included into the phylum Chordata. So bony fish, when we talk about, they have the super class Osteates, and then the other example is the cartilaginous fish. Now we know both the fishes, whether it is the bony fish or it is the cartilaginous fish, they are the generally all the fish are the aquatic animals. So when we talk about the aquatic animals, so aquatic animal are taking the oxygen from the water. Whatever oxygen is dissolved, so approximate 4 to 5 grams per ml water, oxygen is dissolved into the water, 1 liter water. So they have to extract this particular type of oxygen. So dissolved oxygen they have to extract from the water, and for that they have the special aid. But out of that, we are learning the bony fish. We are not going to discuss about the cartilaginous fish, because I told you in the beginning only in the comparative study we have selected the animals which have the special aid in the respiratory organ, or you can say they have the modified respiratory organ. So we are going to talk about the bony fish, but the respiratory organ in all fish or most of the aquatic animal is common. They, that is the gills. You might have watched the video Sepia respiration I shared with you all yesterday. So you might have seen that they were also possessing the gills. Their gills name was different, that is the tenardium. So that means gills are the specialized respiratory organ which can help in extraction of oxygen from the water. So let us discuss a little about the gills. When we talk about the gills, gills are basically of two types, hemibranch and homobranch. When we talk about the hemibranch type of the gills, so it possesses only and only single layer of lamella on it. That means they have only a one side lamella present. But when we talk about the holobranch gills, I will show you the diagram of holobranch gills. This is the holobranch gills. So you will find that the lamellae are present both the sides. So let us begin now. See the basic difference. Now gills, both the fish, bony fish as well as the cartilaginous fish, both the fish, they are possessing the gills. Then what is the special? So the special is that the cartilaginous fish, they continuously move into the water. In our lab, many fish are there in our aquarium. You might have observed that some fish, they do not stop for a single minute. Why? They continuously move forward, because when they move, the water passes from the gill, and whatever water they take, they move outside. So now here, But in the case of the bony fish, they have a special flap or covering. That flap or covering act as a trap door, so which traps the water. So what happens when, that means they have control water exhalation from their body. So whenever they want to expel water outside, they just open their operculum. So operculum act as a trap door. So whenever the fish want to take the water, sorry, want to take the oxygen. So as the source of oxygen is water, they are going to swallow the water, and thereafter, whatever oxygen is present in the water, so that dissolved oxygen will be extracted by the gills, and the gills are going to do the gaseous exchange. Now, let us discuss about the gills as a respiratory organ. Now, what we will have learned, the characteristic of the respiratory organ, we will have learned that it must be thin, it must be highly vascularized, it must have the good surface area, it must be permeable to the water, right? So yes, the gills are made with a very, very, very thin membrane. Those who are eating fish, if they have brought the fish at home, they all might have observed the gills. And if you have not observed, so next time make sure whenever fish is there in your home, so you will observe the gills very carefully, and you will find that it is having the fine, fine, fine brush-like structure. So that brush structure is only and only the your lamellae. So these lamellae are the vessels. So these lamellae increase by making the vascularization. This increase the surface area. So more surface area, more place for the capillary gaseous exchange, right? So this way the gills increase the area, and thereafter you will observe that more number of gills are there. So definitely more and more oxygen can be extracted from the water. So this is basic about the gills. Now let us begin with our today's topic, that is the bony fish. I told you most of the time it is observed that they commonly found into, not it is a compulsory thing, but commonly it is found that the bony fish are present into the water, fresh water. Okay, so first example we all are going to learn is the Rohu. The scientific name is the Labiorohita. Now, when we talk about the Labiorohita, you will find, as just now I told you, that this is the freshwater fish, and it is a very, very common fish. Thereafter, we will be learning the special two gills, or you can say the accessory organ present into the fish. So as now this is bony fish, so gill slits will be covered with the operculum. When you will observe the cartilaginous fish, you will find that the operculum is absent. Now, when we talk about the breathing, so when bony fish breathe, so that particular time the water is prevented to enter inside the gills. Why? Because this operculum has covered the gills, so that's why they are prevented. Now, when they want to extract water, they have the proper control, right? That time only they can move. So unnecessary, they do not require to move forward. Bony fish, they cannot move unnecessarily, so they can breathe without necessarily moving forward into the water. Now, what happens when we talk about the number of gills? So they have the four gills. Now, each and each gills are connected with the bronchial chamber. Now, what happens? This operculum, it is going to act as a pump-like structure. It is going to give suction. So because of that, what is going to be happen? Because of closing of that, it creates the pressure. So water, whatever fish has swallowed, can efficiently move on the gill slits. So that's why the water can be enter into the surface of operculum. Now we will observe this surface of operculum is supported by the bronchiostegial rays, which act as a new one-way valve and allow water to leave. So it is going to act as a valve. So in the case of the bony fish, the water cannot enter from the gills, only and only it can leave or it can exit from the water is being taken inside the body from the mouth. So only one opening for the entry of the water and one opening for the exit. So it is little bit systematic. That means water is taken inside from the mouth, and from mouth it is going to the gills. It is spreading over the gills, and gills is having the closed structure, closed because of the closing. This is going to create a suction like structure. So it is having the pressure, so it is spreading over the gills, and that's why when the water is efficiently spread over all the gill slits, so what is going to be happen? It is going to move outside. As I told you just now, that gills are of two types. So in the case of the bony fish Labiorhynchus, the gills are of hollow branch type. That means it will have the double row of the gill filament, that is called as the gill lamellae. And when you will observe, now see, this lamellae must be having a support, right? So these are supported by the gill arc with the gill wreckers. Now this gill wrecker also helps them into the feeding. When we talk about the two row of the gills, so lamellae, they are separated by the interbranchial septum. You can see the interbranchial septum here now, which is short and compact. It is not till up. Each gill arc bears one afferent and two afferent bronchial waves. So now these vessels, afferent vessels, now when we talk about AFFERENT, afferent vessel, so this afferent vessel, what is the function of it? It brings the deoxygenated blood to it, and the efferent bronchial vessel, they are going to take the oxygenated blood, because the oxygenation is going to occur here. That means the pulmonary respiration occurs here. Okay, now this is about the gills. Now when we talk about the gill filaments, you will find that gill filament extend horizontally from the gill arcs. Now gill filaments, they are going to form many branches. So these small branches are called as the primary lamella. Then this primary lamella will form the secondary lamella. See here, one lamella, then from here many brush like structure are there. So this lamella will be called as the primary lamella, and this basic structure will be called as the secondary lamella. Now this, when we talk about the secondary lamella, so this secondary lamella are highly vascular. These are just you can say our hair like structure, and they run parallel to flow water. You can see they are parallel. So because of this parallel nature, the water can flow from here. Okay, so water will come from here, and efficiently water can spread from here, and they can absorb the water oxygen. Now here the tension of oxygen, now how the this exchange of oxygen is going to be happen? The exchange will occur due to the oxygen tension. Now what is going to be happen in the case of the gills? Inside the gills, water is present. That means the concentration of oxygen is higher. That means the oxygen, this is the fresh water which is just taken by the mouth of a fish. So here the level of oxygen is more, tension of oxygen is high. So for that particular reason, now whatever blood is present, now this gills will efficiently distribute the blood which is deoxygenated. So whatever blood is present, this blood will have the level of carbon dioxide high. So simply we know in the case of the diffusion, what happens? In the case of the diffusion, the molecule or the solute, now here what is the solute? Solute is the carbon dioxide. Solute move from the higher concentration to the lower concentration. Now here the blood which has brought, so that particular blood brought by the efferent bronchial vessel have the higher concentration of the carbon dioxide in it. So this blood will extract whatever carbon dioxide is present in that. It is going to just move that particular carbon dioxide outside. And now whatever water has brought to the fish by mouth, so that particular water has more and more concentration of the oxygen. So for that particular reason, the oxygen will diffuses to the capillary. So this way the deoxygenated blood will become the oxygenated. Understood? Now let us discuss a little about the mechanism of respiration. Now I hope you will have understood that what is going to be happen. Now here one point to be remembered, that the blood will go counter current. Counter current means if the water is moving in this direction, so blood will move in this direction. Because of that, what is going to be happen? Because of this opposite, there is higher concentration to lower concentration. Secondary lamella will occur, and because of that, the efficient oxygen exchange will, sorry, efficient gaseous exchange will occur. Now, gill rakers, this gill raker, I had already discussed that gill raker also supports in the case of the fish feeding also. Now, exactly mechanism means how the respiration occur. Now, we know that the lateral movement of operculum that brings about the respiration. Now, this operculum, they close and open. So, when the operculum are raised, so that particular time, what is going to be happen? It is going to close the bronchiostegial membrane. As I told you, that the operculum, they are attached from their base to the bronchiostegial membrane. So, because of that, this mouth will open. See, I repeat, when the operculum are raised, so that particular time, this bronchiostegial will be closed. And when the bronchiostegial will be closed, so that particular time, this valve, that means the oral valve, that is going to be open. So as the oral valve will open, so it is going to behave like a suction pump. Automatically, the water will enter inside the body. So that particular time, the water will come. So now this water is going to spread here, and very efficiently the exchange of the gases will occur. So that particular time, now you can see this oral valve is open here. Water is taken inside. As soon as the water will be taken, again the mouth will be closed, and thereafter the water will spread on this gills. Okay, so mechanism of respiration will be same in all bony fish. So that's why we will discuss it once. Next two example also we are going to learn about the bony fish, but in that particular example we will not learn the mechanism of the respiration, because the mechanism of respiration will be same, but they will have just the accessory respiratory organ. So mechanism of respiration will not be discussed in later two example. All right, so now see, this is about when the operculum is open. Now when the operculum are lowered, the pressure, now here what happens? The water has come inside, so that particular time the water in the buccal cavity and pharynx will increase. Here the water will increase, so this is going to close the operculum, sorry, oral valves. And now this bronchiostegial membrane will open. Now what will happen when the bronchiostegial membrane will open? water will force out over the gills and out of the operculum cavity. So here it is open. Now when this operculum is going to be open, so that particular time here the low pressure will be there. So automatically the whatever water has been taken inside will spread here and exchange of gas will taken place. Once again we will see what happens when the operculums are closed. So when the operculum are closed, so that particular time the oral wall will open. When the oral valve is open, mouth will also open and this is going to act as a suction pump. So automatically what is going to be happen, water will enter in and thereafter when the water is enter in, so automatically the water will present into the buccal cavity and pharynx will go, will reach here, and as soon as the water is spreaded over the gills, so here the pressure will reduces and this reduced pressure will automatically open the operculum. So as operculum will open, the mouth oral valve will be closed and whatever water is taken in, it will spread here and from here it will go out. So this is about the respiration into the bony fish. The example we have learned is the Labiorohita. In general, we called it as a rohu fish. So we'll stop, but once again, we'll just revise what we have learned. In the case of the bony fish, they have the operculum, and this operculum is acting for, or you can say aiding for the respiration in them, and this operculum helps them to prevent unnecessary forward movement. So in case of the Labiorohita, we have seen they have the four pair of the gills in the branchial chamber. So each branchial chamber is observed, which is covered by the operculum, and we know that the operculum is attached with the branchiostegial membrane at its base, which is present to the posterior. Posterior means the base margin of the operculum. Now when we talk about the gill type, so the gills are of hollow branch, that means it has the double row of the gill filament and it is supported by the gill arc with the gill records. This is the gill record. This gill record also aids into the fish feeding. Now this gill arc, you can see here, it is going to support the two row of the gill lamella. So each gill arc bears the afferent and efferent branchial vessel for what? For the exchange of the gas, that is the carbon dioxide with the present water in it. Then mechanism of oxygen, we have learned that water is entering from the mouth. How water enters? When the operculum is closed, so that particular time here the pressure reduces. Now when the pressure reduces, automatically this valve get open and here this cavity act as a suction pump and this will suck the water inside. So as soon as water is sucked, definitely here the pressure will reduce. Now because of the water in this particular buccal cavity and the pharynx region, the pressure is high. So at compared to this, the operculum pressure is lower. So that particular time, as the pressure into the operculum is reduced, so in the lower pressure the operculum opens, and when the operculum opens, so that particular time water will move from this interbranchial spaces and water will exchange the gases, will take the carbon dioxide present into the blood and will give off its oxygen, and water will leave from the operculum. So this is about the respiration into the bony fish, but we all are going to learn the two more example. In that we will be learning about the special fish, that is the anabas, climbing perch and the clarias. So for this note for today, we will stop. You can definitely ask if you have any doubt to me.